Hey, this is René, and today I want to show you a new expert advisor that has a extremely high hit rate and makes profits with nearly every setup. And it is easy to understand and to trade. It is even better if you can automate it, which I will show you in this video. And this will be very important. I will cover all the pros and cons of such a system, and you will get to know everything 100% transparent. So let us start with explaining how this strategy works. You can see here in my chart, I already placed some lines. These are horizontal lines and they mark price levels. This is just an example. The working expert advisor will of course not look for these price levels, but it's easier for me to explain. So for example, this upper red line is at 1.181 price in the euro US dollar, and the expert advisor may put a buy trade here with a target of 100 points or 10 pips. So the target is at 1.182, this upper green line. And we can see, let's assume that we start here at this point where my crosshair is. And you can see that the take profit is not reached. And then we have another line down here. This is another horizontal line. And it is a there's a gap of 100 points again from the first entry line. And whenever we hit this mark here, we will delete or we close the buy position and open a sell position instead with a higher lot size. The target for this trade is again 100 points, so at this lower green line. And this is pretty much the whole concept of this program. So we either hit the target mark or we hit the level where we opened the first buy trade. And this time we will close this sell trade here and open a new buy trade with an even higher lot size. And yeah, then in this case, we would hit the take profit and then we would do the same again. So you can see that there is not much space for failure. So this system will win pretty much every single setup. There are, of course, risks, and these risks are kind of high, and we will get into it later when we programmed the system. But the key concept is really simple, and it is highly profitable as long as you can have enough margin in your account to hold all the open positions. So I will explain this in a second, but first of all, let me introduce our sponsor for this video, which is Trading Deals.
This video is brought to you by Trading Deals. Trading Deals works with many of the best-known brokers and offers cashback for your trading or other great benefits. Trading fees are often underestimated, but have a huge impact on your trading performance and can even make the difference between winning or losing. Click on the first link in the description and try Trading Deals for free.
Trading Deals helps you to save a lot of your trading commission, so make sure to check out the first link in the description. Okay, so let us start with the programming for this strategy. So this will not be an absolute beginner's tutorial. I made some of these completely beginner tutorials in the past. This will be a little bit more advanced. So I will not cover all the absolute basics and get into it a little bit faster than you might be used to it. But if you are a beginner to programming and to MetaTrader 5 programming, make sure to check out the last videos on this channel, and you will find some more basic tutorials on MetaTrader programming where I explain concepts like variables and loops in more detail. So we will start by creating a new expert advisor. We can call this winning system, for example. You may choose any name that you think fits for this program. And we just click through here. We delete all the unnecessary lines here, which are mainly comments or properties that we do not need for this program. And I rearrange the brackets so it fits my style of programming on, and structuring the code. So first of all, we have a system that is not really bound to any price level. So we can start at any price. It is not really important that we choose a price like the ones I picked for the demonstration, because the basic thought behind the strategy is the idea of the random walk theory, which says pretty much that the market is walking in a random direction and you cannot predict it. So it does not really matter where you put your first entry. And I kind of support this theory because I think many or a high percentage of the price movement is not really predictable. And so this is a great theory to follow and build strategies on top of it. So when we open a position in the MetaTrader 5, the most easy or the easiest ways is to use the trade.mqh file, which we already used before, and use a trade or a ctrade object to open positions. So first of all, we can check if we have any open positions. And we can do that by checking if positions total is equal to zero. Please consider that this position total function returns the total amount of positions in your account. So if you use other strategies and not only this expert advisor, this might lead to a false return value, and you need other ways then to predict the open positions of this expert advisor. But in this case, we will not get into it, and we will just use the positions total function and assume that this will be the only expert advisor running in this account. So if there are no open positions, then we use a trade object to open a buy position. We use a volume that will be defined by the user of this program and a input variable. So the lots can be defined as a input, and then we use the current chart symbol, we use the current price, and yeah, we can have a stop loss and a take profit, which may be defined by the user. SL points. We will just create some inputs for this, and then we can calculate it using the current ask price, which we receive using the symbol info double function, and use the symbol ask identifier to specify what value we want to receive for this specific symbol. So then we can calculate the take profit, which is the ask price plus the TP points multiplied with the underscore point value, which is 0.00001 for the euro US dollar. And then we will use the same formula to calculate the SL price. Make sure to normalize all these values. And we will round it to a precision of the underscore digits value, which is 5 in this case. And then we'll do the same for the TP and the SL. So SL digits. Okay, now we can use these values to open a position that has a SL and a TP value. What we have to do now is we will use the onTrade transaction function, which I will explain in a second. Just open the reference by using by clicking F1 on your keyboard, and then we will just copy the onTrade transaction function. This function is triggered every time a trade transaction is handled by the MetaTrader 5. A trade transaction is, for example, the opening of a new position, the closing of a new position, the modification of a position. So pretty much everything that comes with orders, deals, and positions. And we can check if the transaction type, I think. Let me look it up for a second. Yeah, it is the transaction type. You can see there are many transaction types. What we need is the trade transaction deal at. So we can just check if the type is trade transaction deal at, which means that there is a new deal added to the order history. And then we can simply select this deal. We can use the cDealInfo class for this, which is part of the trade.mqh file. And then we can use deal, and we can say the ticket of this deal is the trans deal variable. This trans is just a structure which you can look up in the reference, of course, and you can see that the deal is indeed the deal ticket here. And then we can check if we can select a history for this deal, or if we can find this deal in the history. But first of all, we have to select a history, and you can select a history but by using the history select function. You have to do this every time before you want to work with deals, because the deals are stored in the history. You can see in this history, you can use a right click to select all the deals, and you can see all these deals are relevant whenever it comes to the opening or the closing of a position. So we can just select the history from the current time minus period seconds of one day. So we have a time period from one day ago to the current time, and you can do it by setting up the history select function like this. As a parameter, we provide the timestamp of the current time minus a whole day and the current time plus 10 seconds. So this makes sure that we have all the relevant deals in our history. And there is a problem somewhere. There is one equal sign missing. This was not a comparing equal sign, but now it should be working. There is another problem. Constant modifier cannot be changed. Okay, there is a false bracket. Okay, now this is working, and now we can check if the deal symbol is like the current chart symbol, and if this is true, we can now check. Maybe we should also provide a magic number, because this way we can ensure that we will only work with the trades opened by this expert advisor, and we will have to set the expert set expert magic number in the onInit function. This will ensure that every trade we open using this trade object here will have the magic number that the user can declare in the inputs. And this is a good way to ensure that we will only work with the deals and positions that have the magic number from this expert advisor. So there is no confusion. And even if there are many trades from different expert advisors, for example, this won't cause any errors. So if we found a new deal, we can now check if the deal type is deal. Let me look it up. Enum deal type. I hope it is the one I'm searching for. Enum deal type. No, I think it's enum deal entry I'm looking for. So deal type is buy sell. Okay, yeah, this is important and we need the deal entry. So let us first search for the entry. Deal entry out means that this is a deal which closes an open position. And now we can check if the deal type is either deal type buy or deal type sell. I think I will have to explain the whole on-trade transaction function one more time after I finished this, because this can be quite confusing. But let us finish this part first. If it's a buy type that closed a open position, that means that there was a open sell position which is now closed. And in this case, we can just take the deal volume and multiply it with a factor. Let us define a lot factor up here, so we can have this deal volume multiplied with the lot factor, and then we should round it, because this might result in a value with more than two digits, which is not a valid value for the lot size. And then we can open a new position, which will be a buy trade, I think. Yes, buy trade. We have to define the volume. We have to define the symbol. We have to define a price and a take profit and a stop loss. I can simply copy all this or even more lines. I copy all these lines here to define the relevant values. We open, this was correct. We open at the ask price. We use a SL and a TP, and that's it. And then we will have to do the same for the other side. So in case there was a buy position closed, then we of course have to open a sell position, and we calculate the TP and the SL using the bid price this time, because we always open market sell positions at the bid price. So we change all this, and this should be enough. So bid, and of course we have to change these. Okay, that's it. So let me add some print statements here. We can have a print statement here which says function closed position, position number. Nah, come on. Trans position and Yeah, this is it. I think it's time for a first test. Let me do a quick test with this expert advisor. We will have the winning system in our tester. If you did not, if you do not know how to open the tester, you can use view and then click on strategy tester. This will open the strategy tester, and then you can click on overview, visualize, and you can select a system here, which will be the winning system in this case. If you choose, if you chose the right name that I chose. So let me start this and let us have a first look on the outcome of this expert advisor. Okay, you can see there were no open positions, of course, and we will open a first position, which is a buy position at the current price. This has a stop loss and a take profit of 100 points as we defined in the inputs here. And now it will be interesting to see what happens if this position is closed. Let me speed it up a little bit. I hope I'm not too fast here. Okay, let us wait a second until the, I think SL is hit here. This may take some time, but I do not want to speed it up too much because this will lead to a extremely fast backtest. Okay, this is close to the SL price now. Yeah. Oh, that was too soon. Okay, here we hit the sell price, and this is not going as expected. So let me look it up in the journal again. I think the problem is that the expert advisor first opens a new first position and then deals with the closing of the last position. But let us look in the journal. We can see that the program realized the position, the closing of position two, which was this first trade here, and it is it is documented in the journal, and then we can see the stop losses triggered, etc., etc., and we have a new market position afterwards, and then we have a sell position. First we have a market buy position, and then we have a sell position. So close position two is printed two times. I think it is because okay, I have to move this print statement down here, because the first execution of this print statement was triggered for the opening of the of this position number two, and the second print statement was triggered after the closing. So now it should only produce the second information, which is this one, and we still have to deal with the problem, because somehow the first position or the second buy position is executed before the sell position is executed. This is a problem, and we will have to deal with it. How can we do this? Okay, I think I found a solution for this. The problem is, in this case, the onTick function is triggered before the trade transaction function. So the expert advisor realized that the open position is closed. So in the onTick function, it says that the position total is equal to zero, and there is a new first position, which is of course not the result that we expected, because we want the on-trade transaction to be triggered first. But we will have to find a solution for this, and the solution might be a global variable. We can call it isTradeAlloyed, and we can say this is true for the start of the program, and then we can check if isTradeAlloyed is true. Then we open the first position and we say if trade is allowed, is then false. If this is if this produced a valid result. So then we have the onTrade transaction function here, and we can see that there are trades opened here. So here in this onTrade transaction, there is no if statement, so we do not check if the trade is allowed. So in this case, we always want to trade if there is a losing trade. So what we have to check is if the deal that caused a position exit, if this was a winning or a losing deal. So we simply have to check if the deal profit is greater than zero. In this case, we can just say if trade is allowed is true, and then we will open a new first position in the next on tick function. And if the profit is not greater than zero, then we have a losing trade, and we will open the next position, which will have a higher lot size, and we will leave the is trade allowed variable false. So let me just restart the whole program, and I hope that this time the result will be better, and we will not have multiple positions after the first one is closed. So this was a little bit too fast. Let me check the results. So we will have we have our first position here, which is a buy position, which is closed here, and then we will have a sell position, which hits the profit, yeah, somewhere here, I think. Let me look in the history. We have a buy position, which makes a loss. Then we have a then we have some more positions. The tester needed some time to update. So we have a sell position which hits the take profit here. So we make a profit of $1 in this case. We have a new buy position which directly hits the take profit. So we make a new we make another profit by in, by out. Yeah, then we wait, let me check it again. We have a buy position, there is a loss. We have a sell position, which is a profit. Then we have a buy position, yeah, this one, which is a profit, $1. Then we have a new buy position. Of course, we always open a buy position first, which is a loss. Then we have a sell position, which is a profit. And then we just opened a new buy position, which is waiting for the trade result. So you can see there are many, many trades, of course, because this system is always invested. And you can indeed see that we always make profits until something happens, which we just saw here somewhere, I think. Yeah, I think we have a high loss. Yeah, then we have the situation that here we have a super high loss because there was a situation where the market just went up a little bit and went down a little bit. So the lot size became really, really big. It's about 80 lots here, and this of course leads to a huge loss, which cannot be covered by this by the account. So the margin requirement is just too high, and there is a stop out. And we can see that in the backtest graph, you can see there is a huge loss in this case because we were not able to provide enough margin, and this leads to a complete loss of this account. So this is the main risk. And what you can do here is you can of course increase the values here. So this will make it a lot more realistic to have profits, because it takes more time to hit the take profit or SL price, and this leads to a more stable outcome of this backtest. Let me show you here. You can see the graph is of course yeah, it indicates the profits, and you also have losing streaks, but these should not be as high as they were in the last test, because now we have more space to hit the SL price. And if there are situations where the price is moving up and down a little bit, the chance is simply lower that we have a total loss, because the range is bigger. So you can see this is working pretty good, and this is why I said there is a very high win rate. And if we look at the backtest, you can see that the win rate is, of course, for every single trade around 50%, because we have the same range from the entry to the take profit price and from the entry to the stop loss price. But for a whole setup, so for this for one streak of trades, the win rate is extremely high. It's around, I don't know, 99%, I think, because it is really the chances are really big to make a profit. And yeah, we just made made a profit of $2,000 for this tested time period. I think, I don't know how long it was. It was from 2017 to 2021. And you can, of course, increase the profits if you increase the lot size. So if I simply put up the lots, the starting lots to 0.1, you will of course have a much higher outcome after the 3 or 4 years tested. You can see in the graph, it is the same system, the same setup, everything is the same, but the starting lot size is increased, which will of course increase the outcome, but it will on the other hand of course increase the risk. So after all this, after seeing that this system can perform extremely well, we also have to talk about the risk. It is like everything in life, nothing comes free. So in this case, you will of course have a really high possibility of winning money, but you will also have a high or a higher risk, and you will have to use this system extremely with caution, and you may have a high loss, or maybe even just destroy your whole account. So this is the risk you have to take to achieve a performance that is extremely good with an easy system like this. But let us talk about the system one last time. I did a fast programming part this time, but I will explain some of the things a little bit slower now. So first of all, we include the trade file to be able to use the Ctrade class, as I explained in some other tutorials. We have several input variables. These are the variables that we can see in the inputs window here, and we can see that we can simply adjust them here to change the outcome of the test. Then we have the onInit function, where we simply set the expert advisor magic number, so we can make sure that we will only react to the right deals in the onTrade transaction function. Then we have the onTick function, which has the relevant code for the opening of the first position. Every time the isTradeAllowed variable, which is a global variable here, is true, then we open a buy position at the current market price, and we have a TP and a SL, which is defined in points by the user via the input variables. After opening the very first position, which is always a buy position in this case, we set the isTradeAllowed variable to false. That's it for the onTick function. The onTick function is only responsible for opening the first trade if there are no open trades. Then we have the onTradeTransaction function. This function is a system function which is fired every time there is a trade transaction. So if there is a deal opened, a deal closed, or a deal a position opened, a position closed, if there is a new deal, if an order is modified, and so on. So we search for a specific scenario, which is the trade transaction deal at event. And this event, as you can see in the documentation, of course, is defined as the adding of a deal to the history. I already explained this. You can see in the terminal, if you click on history, there are a lot of deals. And a deal is added to the history whenever a position is opened. This is the direction in, or if there is a position closed, which is the direction out. And we can capture this event in the onTradeTransaction function. And then we can simply have a closer look at this specific deal. We can use the cDealInfo class, which is part of the trade.mqh file here. I can show you in this trade file, you can see there is a include line, which includes the deal info, and the deal info has the cDealInfo class, which we use here. And the cDealInfo class, it handles all the necessary it provides all the necessary functions to receive the properties of this deal. And many of these functions are really, really simple to understand. They just use the history, deal get, integer, double, whatever, for a specified ticket. And we specify the ticket in our expert advisor in this line, where we say that for this deal, we provide the ticket which we receive from the MQL trade transaction structure, and we use the deal variable in this structure. Then we select a history, so we can we get access to the deal parameters, and we have to select a history, and I simply selected the history for the last day using this time window here, which will ensure that we can select this deal, and we can we have access to the deal's properties, and we check if the deal magic number is equal to our magic number for this expert advisor, and we check if the deal symbol is equal to the chart symbol. Then we check if this was a deal that was made because a position was closed. So we have to check if the deal entry is equal to deal entry out. Then we make this print statement, and then we check if the deal profit is greater than zero. In this case, we say that is trade allowed is true, which will then lead to the opening of a new position in the next onTick function. And if the profit is smaller than zero, which says that our trade hit the SL mark, then we check if this was a deal to close a sell position. In this case, we open a new buy position, or if this was a deal to close a sell position, a buy position. In this case, we open a new sell position. And that's it. So really, really, really easy program. It's a simple strategy, but it is still very, very effective. And there are, of course, many ways how you can modify the strategy. For example, you can make the first trade at a specific time of the day, or you can have a filter for the first trade. And you can have many, many different settings for the opening of the first trade. And you can, of course, also play around with the TP points, the SL points, and the lot factor. If you copied this, the source code, you can use it in your own MetaTrader 5 at your PC. And you can, of course, play around with this concept. So all in all, this is a winning system. As long as you have enough money to provide margin for your broker, so the broker lets you open more positions. After several trades, the possibility to hit the take profit is extremely high, but it is simply a game of how long can you provide enough margin for your broker. This is the crucial question, which will make the difference between winning or losing. Please keep in mind that this system is extremely dangerous, because even though the performance may look really nice for the times when the system is making profits, there is always the possibility of a long time without a clear trend, and in this situations, this system can produce a complete breakdown of your account, and you may realize huge losses. So this is it for today's video. I hope you liked it. I hope you learned something in the small programming part. And yeah, let me know what you think about systems like this. Systems like this are really close to GRID or Martingale systems, of course, because they have different features from these systems. So let me know what you think about it in the comments below. And I hope we will see each other in the next video on this channel. Until then, have a nice time, and good trades. Bye-bye.